Well, I said the next video, the front inner fenders and core support were going to be painted. And they are. This is going to be a short video, because I didn't want to have my camera in the garage while I was spraying. Came out pretty good. I took the front off and really didn't have any place to set it to spray it properly. And I unbolted all this so I could totally pull this out. And I just kind of rested on the bolt in there. But it looks good. I wish it was a little shinier. I'll probably never use their product again. I'm not like as happy as I thought I'd be with it. I thought it would be a little glossier. That's more like a satin black than a semi-gloss, but it'll look good because it'll be a little bit of contrast from the frame. It's nice when you have a little bit of contrast from things, because it, you know, it really looks good then. It looks like you did it, you know, took it all apart, which I did. I, like I say, I took this off, and then I'm deciding where am I going to put it to paint it, and to where I can paint it easily. And I just found right back on the car was the best place to spray it. And you know, it came out pretty darn good. I saved just a little bit, so if I scratch it, I can touch it up if I scratch it while I'm putting it together. But I gotta be careful I don't lean into it, because it is still kind of damp. Looks really good. Totally happy with it. So next is the cowl, and then I can start putting the machinery back, you know, put the brakes on, put the machinery back in, and get the fenders painted up and back on. So that was a pretty good size step. I'll show you the gun I used too. I use my little door jam gun, HVLP gun. The reason why I use this is because little parts like this are, you know, where it's some tight areas. This gun gets into tight areas. I love this gun too. My favorite one's that Badger 400 door jam gun, but for painting parts in small areas. But when I'm spraying in the garage, I use this, and then I put that box fan in that window blowing out, and it was doing a, I opened the back garage door with that fan blowing out. It pretty much removed all the air, all the overspray right out of the garage. So I really had very little overspray in the garage using this gun. Or if I was using my Badger, I'll show you. This is my little Badger. I love this. So this is my favorite spray gun of all the spray guns I own. It's a Badger model 400. I use this to paint the steering gear, all the little pieces. Just so nice, you know, it works nice. It's kind of like using a spray can, you know, you just kind of grab it and you can, you know, I just, more you push it, the more paint, less you push it, less paint. Just really nice gun. But again, you know, this is the gun to use when you're painting indoors. Now I run this gun at about 25-30 psi to where the Badger, I run this gun at 60 psi. The other gun, HVLP, means high pressure, low volume. Or, I'm sorry, high volume, low pressure. Got it backwards there. So it moves a lot of paint at very little pressure, so you don't get a lot of overspray. And when I paint the body, like the cowl, I'll probably paint with the HVLP door jam gun. But when I'm painting these main body parts, if I'm painting them in the garage, I'll use the HVLP gun. Probably use this gun when I paint the green. That's a primer gun, paint gun. The other one, obviously, door jam gun. All the little filters for the little filter goes in right here where your paint can goes on. Yeah, and you need one of these stands. This will accommodate both guns, but both size guns. But you need one of these stands, because these don't sit up like these guns do. So yeah, you need a stand. Oh, and you can see I got the brake booster there. I'm going to start working on getting that master off. I'm going to wait until that paint tacks up before I do anything more in the garage. So I'll let this dry a couple hours and I'll demask it and clean up the mess in the garage, you know. And I just want it totally dry to the touch before I start horsing around in here. This is the paint I used. Next will be all this. Clean the seam sealers out. Maybe this weekend, tomorrow or the next day, I'll start working on this, and then that'll be the next thing painted. And I want to do something with the air box here to make it look a little nicer. After I'm done painting this, I'll work on this. And then I'm going to put the brakes on, the steering gear in, and then I'll put the engine and transmission back in. Looks really good. I'm really, really pleased. You know, I think it was originally a little glossier, but that's Eastwood's formula for inner fender paint. It looks really nice. Alright, like I say, this is just going to be a short video. I just wanted to show the inner fenders painted up and the radiator core support painted up. So I'm pretty happy with it. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you want to see this cool old Galaxie restored, subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching.